Dear students, I welcome you all for the sixth module of Science and Technology Part 1, Metallurgy Chapter. In this module, we will be learning about corrosion of metals, prevention of corrosion of metals, in that about galvanizing, tinning, anodization, electroplating and alloying. Now, let us recollect our previous module. High reactive metals can be obtained by oxidation or reduction through electrolysis. Extraction of aluminium can be done by two methods, Bayes process and Hall's process. The alumina obtained at the end of this process is made to undergo electrolytic reduction, where we obtain molten aluminium at the cathode and oxygen liberated at the anode. Moderately reactive metals can be obtained by roasting or calcination. Roasting is heating the metals in the presence of air, especially used for sulfide ores, whereas calcination is also heating but in limited supply of air, especially for carbonate ores. Then thermit welding is used to weld rails. This uses the exothermic reaction of metal oxides being reduced to form metals. Then the less reactive metals can be extracted by heating in air. So the metals obtained by all these processes cannot be said that it is pure. So it is further purified by electrolysis process. Today we are going to start with learning about corrosion of metals. What is corrosion? Corrosion is a natural process that converts a refined metal into a more chemically stable form, such as its oxide, hydroxide or sulfide. It is the gradual destruction of materials, usually a metal, by chemical and or electrochemical reaction with their environment. Corrosion degrades the useful properties of metals and structures, including its strength and appearance. First, we will learn about rusting of iron. Rust is an iron oxide, a usually reddish brown oxide formed by the reaction of iron and oxygen in the presence of water or air. Given sufficient time, any iron mass in the presence of water and oxygen could eventually convert entirely to rust. Rusting is the common term for corrosion of elemental iron and its alloys such as steel. Many other metals undergo similar corrosion, but the resulting oxides are not commonly called rust. Rusting of iron articles causes large financial loss. Then about patination of copper. Carbon dioxide in the moist air reacts with the surface of the copper vessel. Copper loses its luster due to formation of greenish layer of copper carbonate on its surface. Now, we will learn about tarnishing of silver. When silver is exposed to sulfur containing gases in the air, it discolors and then darkens as it reacts with the gas to form a surface layer of tarnish. This process is called tarnishing. A layer of silver sulfide is formed by the reaction of silver with hydrogen sulfide in air. This leads to the darkening of silver articles. Next, about corrosion of aluminium. Aluminium corrosion is the gradual decay of aluminium molecules into its oxide that degrades its physical and chemical properties. By nature, if we see, aluminium is a reactive metal, but it also a passive metal. What does it mean? It means that aluminium will react with oxygen and water in the environment. The result is the formation of a layer on the surface of the metal. It protects it from further corrosion. This non-reactive oxide layer sticks well to the surface and it does not flake off easily. So thus, the corrosion of aluminium will be prevented. Let us concentrate on prevention of corrosion. Corrosion of metals can be stopped by keeping metals isolated from a direct contact with air. We know that most of this corrosion happens with direct interaction of metals with air. If we can stop this, we can prevent corrosion. There are various methods used to protect metals from corrosion. So we can lower the rate of process of rusting of iron, especially due to these processes. The prevention of corrosion can be achieved by various means, like to fix a layer of some substance on the metal surface so that the contact of the metal with moisture and oxygen in the air is prevented and no reaction would occur between them. Hence, corrosion can be prevented. Or to prevent corrosion of metals by applying a layer of paint, oil, grease or varnish on their surface. This also prevents direct contact of air with the metal. So, corrosion of iron can be prevented by this method. So, under prevention of corrosion, can we permanently prevent the rusting of iron article by applying a layer of paint on its surface? Actually, we cannot. Painting is suitable only for a short time. If there is a scratch on the paint on the surface of the article and if a small surface of the metal comes in contact with air, the process of rusting starts below the layer of paint. So, it is suitable only for a short time. See, if you see new iron sheets, they appear very shiny. Why this is so? Because a layer of a non-corrodible metal is applied on the iron sheet to prevent it from corrosion. So, it is time we will learn about various methods to prevent corrosion. The first method we are going to learn is about galvanizing. In this method, a thin layer of zinc is applied to prevent corrosion of iron or steel. For example, the shining iron nails, pins, etc. are galvanized articles. Here, the corrosion of zinc occurs first because zinc is more electropositive than iron. After a few rainy season, the zinc layer goes away and the inner iron gets exposed. Then the iron starts rusting. So, galvanization is a long process. It is a layer of zinc being applied over iron or steel to prevent corrosion. The next process is tinning. What is tinning? In this method, a layer of molten tin is deposited on metals. If you see, the greenish layer on the surface of copper or brass vessel is poisonous. So, if buttermilk or if we are placing a curry in such vessel, it gets spoiled. So, tinning is done to prevent such damages. Anodization. Anodizing is an electrolytic process used to increase the thickness of natural oxide layer of the surface of metal parts. This process is called anodizing because the part to be treated forms the anode electrode of the electrolytic cell. So, anodizing increases the resistance to corrosion and wear and provides better adhesion for paint primers and glues than bare metal does. In this method, metals like copper, aluminium are coated with a thin and strong layer of their oxides by means of electrolysis. For this, the copper or aluminium article is used as anode. As this oxide layer is strong and uniform all over the surface, it is useful for prevention of corrosion of the metal. Take for example, when aluminium is anodized, the thin layer of aluminium oxide is formed. It obstructs the contact of the aluminium with oxygen and water. So, this prevents further oxidation of the metal. So this protection can be further increased by making the oxide layer thick during the anodization. Now we are going to learn about electroplating. Electroplating is a general name for a process that creates a metal coating on the solid substrate through the reduction of cations of that metal by means of a direct electric current. The part to be coated acts as a cathode of an electrolytic cell. The electrolyte is the solution of the salt of the metal to be coated, and the anode is usually either a block of the metal or of some inert conductive material. The current is provided by an external power supply. Electroplating is widely used in industry and decorative arts to improve the surface quality of the object, such as its resistance to corrosion or appearance. It may also be used to build up thickness on the undersized or worn out parts, or to manufacture metal plates. It is also used to purify metals such as copper. In this method, a less reactive metal is coated on a more reactive metal by electrolysis. Silver plated spoons, gold plated ornaments are the examples of electroplating. The next process to prevent corrosion is alloying. Many metallic substances used are in the form of alloys to decrease the intensity of corrosion of metals. The homogeneous mixture formed by mixing a metal with other metals or non-metals in certain proportion is called an alloy. The resulting mixture forms a substance with properties that often differ from those of the pure metals, such as it will have an increased strength or hardness. Take for example, bronze is an alloy formed from 90% copper and 10% tin. Bronze statues do not get affected by sun and rain. So stainless steel is an alloy made from 74% iron, 18% chromium and 8% carbon, and it does not get stains with air or water and also does not rust. Alloys are used in wide variety of application, from the steel alloys used in everything from buildings to automobiles to surgical tools, etc. In some cases, a combination of metals may reduce the overall cost of the material while preserving important properties. So, in recent times, various types of alloys are used for minting coins also. Now, we are going to learn about amalgam. Amalgam is an alloy of mercury with another metal. It may be a liquid, a soft paste, or a solid, depending upon the proportion of the mercury. These alloys are formed through metallic bonding. Almost all metals can form amalgam with mercury, except iron, platinum, and tungsten. Silver-mercury amalgams are important in dentistry, and gold-mercury amalgam is used in the extraction of gold from the ore. Dentistry has used alloys of mercury with metals such as silver, copper, indium, tin, and as well as zinc also. In this picture, you are seeing a thin layer of gold being kept on a drop of mercury. You can see how the mercury is dissolving the thin layer of gold and converting it into amalgam. Amalgam has various industrial applications. So we have come to the end of the module. Let us summarize the points. Corrosion is a process in which metals destroy by chemical reaction with their environment. Corrosion of metals can be stopped by keeping metals isolated from a direct contact with air. To fix a layer of some substance on the metal surface, or by applying a layer of paint, oil, grease, or varnish on their surface prevents corrosion. Then about methods to prevent corrosion, the first one is galvanizing. In this method, a thin layer of zinc is applied especially over iron or steel to prevent corrosion. Then tinning. In this method, a layer of molten tin is deposited on metals. This is especially done with copper articles. Then about anodization, metals like copper, aluminium, they are coated with a thin and strong layer of their corresponding oxide by means of electrolysis process. Then we have learned about electroplating, where a less reactive metal is coated on a more reactive metal by electrolysis process. So then alloy. Alloy is a homogeneous mixture formed by mixing a metal with other metals or non-metal in certain proportion. This is one promising method to prevent corrosion of metals. Then when one metal in an alloy is mercury, then such alloy is called as amalgam. Amalgam has various applications. So we have completed the chapter, children. Thank you for listening.